Dear students, previous classes we will detailed discussed about the characteristics in pteridophytes such as habitat or occurrence and thallus organization or plant body organization. Today we are going to discuss about the characteristics in pteridophytes such as reproduction. Reproduction, it's may be asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. Let us discuss about the first one, asexual reproduction. So dear students, the sporophyte bears sporangia that are subtended by leaf like appendages called sporophylls. In generally in pteridophytes, the plant body is a sporophyte, that is a diploid stage or asexual stage. Okay, now so the sporophyte bears one type of asexual organs, that is sporangia. So this sporangia that are subtended by leaf like appendages, subtended by leaf like appendages, that is called sporophylls. So sporophylls first to be appeared in pteridophytes of asexual reproduction, especially sporophytes would be bears sporangia. These sporangia that subtended leaf like appendages, that is called sporophylls. Once again, the sporophyte bears sporangia, one type of spores that are subtended by leaf like appendages called sporophylls. Sporophylls, these are asexual organs. Some leaves to be produced asexual spores, some leaves to be produced asexual spores, that is called sporophylls, another definition are here. And the development of the sporangium may be leptosporangiate and eusporangiate. The sporophyte bears sporangia that are subtended leaf like appendages, that is called sporophylls. So the sporangium developed may be leptosporangiate and eusporangiate. Leptosporangiate means the development of sporangia from a single superficial cell. Single superficial cell, that is called leptosporangiate. Okay, now the development of sporangia, the development of sporangia from a single superficial cell, that is called leptosporangiate. And eusporangiate, the development of sporangia from a group of superficial cells, from a group of superficial cells, superficial cells, that is called eusporangiate. Okay, now the development of the sporangium may be leptosporangiate and eusporangiate. Leptosporangiate means the development of sporangia from a single superficial cell, and eusporangiate, the development of sporangia from a group of superficial cells, that is leptosporangiate and eusporangiate. Next one is here, the sporangia produce spores by meiosis in spore mother cells. The sporangium or sporangia would be containing several spore mother cells. These spore mother cells undergo meiosis or reduction division to be produced several spores. Okay, now the sporangia produce spores by meiosis or reduction division in spore mother cell. Okay, now by means, the spore mother cells would be containing sporangium. The sporangium of spore mother cells undergo meiosis or reduction division would be produced to several spores. So these spores are similar in size. That is known as homosporous. And some spores are different kinds of structures. Some of them are here smaller in size. Some of them are here larger in size. That is microspores, and that is megaspores or macrospores. So this phenomenon is known as heterospores. Okay, now the sporangia produce spores. These spores are differ in different plants. For example, Marsilia and Adiantum. The spores are all are similar in size. All are macro in size. That is macrospores or microspores. There is no variation. Okay, now the spores are similar in size. That is called homosporous. Homosporous are seen in pteridophytes of Marsilia and Adiantum. But here spores are different in size. Some spores are larger in size and some spores are smaller in size. That is microspores and macrospores to be appeared in some species of pteridophytes. That is Salazinella and Salvinia. Salazinella and Salvinia. This phenomenon are named as heterosporous. Okay, now but here in bryophytes all are homosporous. Okay, now in bryophytes all spores are similar in size. That is homosporous. But in pteridophytes some of them are homosporous and some of them are heterosporous. So two types of phenomenon are appeared in pteridophytes. That is homosporous and heterosporous. Next, coming to in some cases sporophylls. In some cases sporophylls may form distinct compact structures in sporophylls. So in some cases sporophylls may form. So this is a sporophyll. So this is a axis and these are the sporophylls. So these sporophylls may form distinct compact structure. Distinct compact structure closely packed to be sporophylls. Closely packed to be sporophylls. Okay, now closely packed sporophylls. That is known as cones or strobili. Cones are strobili. Okay, now in some cases sporophylls may form distinct compact structures. Distinct compact structures by means sporophylls all are closely packed. That is known as strobili or cones. That is known as strobili or cones. So this strobili or cones are seen in Salazinella and Equidgetum. Salazinella and Equidgetum. Dear students, in pteridophytes in generally the sexual stage to be appeared sporophylls. But some of the Salazinella and Equidgetum in those of sporophylls may form distinct compact structures. Distinct compact structures by means sporophylls may closely packed. Sporophylls may closely packed. So that is strobili or cones. Given the examples are here Salazinella and Equidgetum. Salazinella and Equidgetum. So this is a strobili or this is a one cone. Next, coming to sexual reproduction. After some time, so these spores, either homosporous or heterosporous. So the spores germinate to give rise to inconspicuous, small but multicellular, free living, mostly photosynthetic thalloid gametophytes. That is called prothallus. In sexual reproduction in pteridophytes, most of the to be appeared one prothallus. What is meaning of prothallus? Okay, now so the spores germinate to give rise to inconspicuous and smaller in size but multicellular and free living mostly photosynthetic, green in color, to be prepare a own their food material. Thalloid, not differentiated, true root, true stem, true leaves, and gametophyte, that is called prothallus. Gametophyte is also in pteridophytes. The gametophyte is also known as prothallus. Prothallus. Why? Because this is a smaller in size, multicellular, free living, mostly photosynthetic thallus.
prothallus would be containing sex organs. This gametophytes or prothallus would be containing sex organs. By means the gametophyte or the prothallus bearing the sex organs. So in this sex organs are multicellular, jacketed and sessile. In bryophytes, the sex organs are multicellular, jacketed and stalked. But here in pteridophytes, the sex organs are multicellular. So the body organization made up of more than two cells and covered with the cells, that is jacketed and sessile, not to supporting of the stalk. Not supporting of the stalk. Stalk is absent, that is sessile. The sex organs are multicellular, jacketed and sessile. Stalk is absent. Foot is absent. Next coming to, so pseudogamous oogamy. Pseudogamous oogamy. So by means the flagellated motile male gamete reach within the non-motile female gamete, that is called pseudogamous oogamy. In bryophytes and in pteridophytes, the fertilization takes place in pseudogamous oogamy. By means motile or flagellated male gamete fused within the non-motile female gamete or egg, that is called pseudogamous oogamy. Okay, now the motile male gamete is always within the fuse of female gametophyte of egg cell. Female gametophyte of egg cell. So in this time, the male gamete within the fuse of female gametophyte of egg cell within the form of one diploid zygote. So this diploid zygote after some time to be form of embryo undergoes mitosis. But here the female gametophyte, so in these plants, is always retained on the parent sporophyte for variable periods. This is very very important over here. In generally, the male gamete fused within the female gamete of egg cell in their female gametophyte. But here the female gametophytes in these plants retained on the parent sporophyte for variable periods. So this event is precursor to the seed habit. So this is considered as an important step in evolution. In generally, the male gamete within the fuse of the female gamete to be form of one diploid zygote. So after some time, the diploid zygote undergoes mitosis to be form of one diploid embryo. This embryo to be form of seed. This embryo after some time to be making a one seed. But here the female gametophytes in these plants retained on the parent sporophyte, on the parent plant body for variable periods. This event is precursor to the seed habit, before the seed habit. So this is considered an important step in evolution. So in this gametophyte, after some time to be germinate and to be well developed, the plant body of sporophyte. This is about the asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction in pteridophytes. Okay, now thank you.